There are several theories about how our universe began, but the most widely accepted one is called the Big Bang Theory. This theory proposes that the universe came into existence about 13.8 billion years ago, following a massive explosion. The leftover radiation from the Big Bang is known as cosmic microwave background radiation, or the CMB. The Big Bang Theory is favored because some experimental evidence supports it. If the Big Bang did occur, we would expect to observe specific characteristics in our universe that could only result from such a monumental explosion. The Big Bang Theory suggests that the universe began to expand rapidly after a massive explosion. If this theory is accurate, we should observe other galaxies moving away from ours. This phenomenon was indeed observed in the 1920s, when Edwin Hubble, using his telescope, reported that galaxies farther away from us are receding more quickly than those that are closer. This observation, now known as Hubble's Law, provided strong support for the Big Bang Theory. Additionally, the theory posits that such a colossal explosion would have generated a characteristic radiation spectrum that we could still detect today. This radiation is known as the cosmic microwave background, the residual energy from the Big Bang. According to NASA, the existence of cosmic microwave background radiation was first predicted by American cosmologist Ralph Alpher while he was collaborating with George Gamow and Robert Hermann. However, it was accidentally discovered 17 years later, in 1965. Arno Penzias and Robert Wilson, two researchers from Bell Telephone Laboratories, were working on a radio receiver when they noticed an unusual and persistent noise. This noise seemed to be coming not from a single source, but from all directions in the sky. Around the same time, Robert Dickey was leading a team at Princeton University that was actively searching for the CMB. When Dickey's team learned about the observations made by Penzias and Wilson, they realized that the CMB had been discovered. In the earliest stages of the universe, it was a minuscule fraction of its current size, about 1/100,000,000th of what it is today. At that point, temperatures were extremely high, preventing the formation of stable atoms, as collisions between particles continually knocked electrons away. This also caused the universe to be opaque, as photons could not travel very far. However, approximately 380,000 years after the Big Bang, the temperature cooled enough for the first stable atoms to form. With this cooling, photons began to travel freely, and the universe became transparent. This transparency allows us to map the cosmic microwave background today, enabling us to look back at the early years of our universe when the very first elements began to emerge. Cosmic microwave background radiation is present everywhere in the universe, but we can't see it with the naked eye, as it is mostly visible in the microwave region of the electromagnetic spectrum. This is similar to why we can't see infrared or X-rays without specialized equipment. Each point on a CMB map carries vital information about the early days of our universe. By studying the CMB, we gain insights into the conditions that existed shortly after the Big Bang, understanding what the universe was like at that time, including its shape, size, temperature, and the formation of the first elements. This is why NASA referred to the observations made by the Cosmic Background Explorer as the first baby picture of the universe. In this way, it's fair to say that the CMB, which surrounds us, connects us to our distant collective past, a past that continues to inspire awe and remains a fascinating mystery to solve.